What I'm about to show you, it is not a step-by-step. What I'm about to show you, it is not a step-by-step tutorial, but it's a DIY hack. Stick around. Although this is not a step-by-step tutorial, I do want to show you some of the stuff that we are working around the warehouse of Battery Hookup. Basically, we built a DIY spot welder, and it's an ongoing process to show you how to build it. But in the meantime, I'm just going to show you the different parts that we use, how we put it together, and also the circuit board that it's only a prototype, but I'm going to make a PCB for that so you could build your own house and have your own spot welder. Now, rest assured, we already test this, and we also use fusing with it, which is a really drawback when you're building a DIY spot welder. Most of the time, you don't have fusing with it. I think we tackled this one, and it's beautiful. Let me just show you the different parts that we're doing. I'm going to try to explain as much as possible. And like I said, it is not a step-by-step tutorial. That's going to come in the future. When I get back to Puerto Rico, I'm doing it step-by-step. So let me just show you this. So first off, we have lithium polymer batteries, or they are best known on the market as flat cells. We have two of them in parallel. These batteries are actually 8 amp hours capacity, but they can actually output 200 amps constantly, like discharge constantly. But also you could do in a dead short. If you do a dead short on these, they could actually output 500 amps. I really like these batteries. And this is the heart of the spot welder. Also, we have your typical car battery cable. This is 6 gauge wire. We have one over here. This is just a solenoid. It's mostly used to turn on lawnmowers and little go-karts and stuff like that. And right now, it's just being used to pass all the current from the negative side. Like when the current goes like this, it goes back on and gets activated over here. We are using a small 12 volts, probably 1 amp battery as our main trigger. And over here we have our circuit board. Now this is a prototype, and I'm gonna do a full tutorial on how to make this. And we are also gonna have like a little DIY kit that you can get and build something like that for yourself. You have right now some capacitors, a relay, 2 push buttons, and some switches. And this is where you input. This is where you input your current, and it goes like that. And basically, if you just press right here, right now they're moving all around. Just press like that. That little click that they heard, it's this. So let me just try it again, so you can just listen to it. There you go. So basically, this is the whole project right here. And like I said, I'm going to do a tutorial, like a step-by-step how to make this. Now, we are using this battery for just one reason. It is something that we have available, but most of the guys out there are actually using 12 volts lead-acid batteries. We are estimating that we're probably outputting close to 400 amps out of these. We don't have a clamp measure to know how much we're getting out of it. But this is the results. This is the battery that we put together using that one. It's like super strong. It's not going anywhere. But I want to show you. Let's see if this camera focuses. If not, let me just try this. You take a look. There's no burn marks. Now, don't take my word for it. Let me just show you. So right now, I'm going to show you this battery right here. I'm actually pulling really hard. As you can see, it took a lot of strength to just take it out. And I do believe that once it's there, you don't have to move it around. But you can always try to be safe. Like I said, this is a hack, and we're trying to test new stuff out. because I know for sure some of you guys want to do a spot welder and you want to use the lithium polymer cells. So let's see. Let me just show you. So this is a battery that we're going to use. I already scraped out the top of it. Let's try to get this. Now I'm ready to activate this. Let's see how it goes. That's one. That's two. So you can see, like, if I really pull this out, it's gonna come out. Probably it's not gonna rip it. Now this nickel is pretty thick, and I think that's why I'm not getting like a really good contact. I'm gonna do a three pulse and see how that changed. So right now I'm gonna do this one, this two, and this three. Now this one feels a lot stronger too. There you go. I think that's a winner for me. So there you go. This is a work in progress, and hopefully it's gonna be something that is gonna help you guys to build better packs. We did try it with fusing and it kind of works. Hopefully when I do the step-by-step tutorial on how to make this, I will have more information on how to build, how to use it with nickel strips and also fusing. But in the meantime, I hope you enjoyed this short video. But this is just to answer some of the people out there that were talking to me about this. So, see you in the next one. Bye. Just a short reminder, this video has been sponsored by Battery Hookup. You guys know Tom, he's been more than great for me. Like, he's been helping me around. And that's why you see this behind me. Right now we are in Pennsylvania, and this is my last day. And this video completely was sponsored by him. Like, the batteries, the cell, the cables, everything. So I'm really happy that I get to do this. There's gonna be a link below if you wanna get these batteries, or if you just wanna buy another battery, just visit the link of Battery Hookup and get whatever you need. And also it's gonna help me continue doing stuff for you guys. Now, I'll see you later. Bye.